Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel Skill RPA. And so this is the second video on second session, I can say, in the series of real-time use cases, supply chain management. And today we are going to discuss about to-be flow, how we are going to create a to-be flow. And as of now, like I'm just trying to explain you what actually I do in my work, from where I generally create the flows and all. So this is the website, like from where I generally create the flows and all, app.diagrams.net. And I just will go with the create new diagram, and I'll just give a name, like it's a supply chain management as is process, right? So I'll just give only supply chain management. I don't want to give either it is an as is or to be, because I want to create both under the same file. So let me supply chain management. And in case if you are not clear about the requirements, please watch out my previous video in this playlist, and I'll give the link in the description as well in order to go through that video. So let me create this, and I just want to save it on the downloads, and I'll just mention supply chain management create. I'll go with a blank diagram. I'm just going with a blank diagram, and at any point of time the start will be the starting point for this. And let me write start, and if you want any some fancy colors or something, like you can just try it out from here. So first, what actually we need to do is, like, we need to open the supply chain management application, the web application. So let me go for the next one, which is, so I just want to have some I prefer to go with this. What the generally user used to do is, like, it you they'll come to, because this is as is, right? So first let me rename this sheet name to as is process. We rename, and the user will open supply chain management portal. Yes, let me connect these two dots. Yeah, and after that, what user will do is, like, he will download the agent territory spreadsheet. Let me close this. And after this, like, they'll click on the procurement anywhere, and they'll take the username from here. Okay, first they'll click on the procurement anywhere application link in order to get it opened in a new session. So user clicks on procurement application URL. So after that, like, user will capture the username and password from here, and they will log into the procurement application. Username and password from supply app, and logs into procurement application. It's done. Now let me just resize it and make it a bit easy. Okay. So let me connect these things. Okay. And now once the user logs in, it's done. And now what user will do is capture the purchase order number. So here I just need to loop through multiple purchase order numbers, right? So now the taking of purchase order number is fine, but how it is going to be, like how it can be looped? Purchase order number is available. Let me refresh this because we have the data here, right? So let me refresh this. Yeah, so I got a new purchase order numbers. So okay, let me see, let me consider this, like for each purchase order number I need to fill up the ship date, order detail, and okay, new purchase order number is available. So now I just need to check for a condition. New. Let me just expand that so that like every text will be visible properly. Yeah, this looks to be okay. Yes, got it. So let me keep in center for everything. Yeah. So close. No. First, I need to click on submit. No, login is done, and I need to get back to this again. The new purchase order number is available. So, what I'm planning to do is, let me delete this. Let me just try to resize it properly. Okay, but the things are not as expected for me, and how I can do. Okay, got it. So let me just bring this bit more down. I just want to make sure that the flow looks to be a bit look, it should be look good, right? Like whenever we are doing some flows, then it should be look good. So now what I need to do is click on submit button. And then I need to log out and close all the applications. So this is what I need to do when there is no any new purchase order number. So this will be, I just want some more space here in order to give the condition. Okay. Let me just drag it a bit more down. And let me just try to give a text. Yeah, it is no. And now I can just adjust a bit more up so that like it can be adjusted. Yeah, it's done. Now, if I have, then search PO number in procurement application. Yes, this is what actually the user is doing right now. Copy this from here and search it here. Yeah, and need to capture ship date, order date, and this date. let us say capture ship date. Order total and state. Okay. Now what I need to do is we downloaded the agent spreadsheet, right? So from there we need to get the agent name based on the state. Get agent name from agent territory spreadsheet. Done. Now we need to input all the information into the supply chain management application. Input ship date, space here, order total, agent name in supply chain management application. Yeah, it's done. Okay. And now after this, once it was done, it should go for if the next purchase number is available or not. He will look for the next number, and if it is not available, so it will, he will look for each purchase number, and once he reaches here, then there is no purchase number, and then he will be clicking on submit. And this is our actual flow, as is flow. And now we need to look for to be flow as well. And when it comes to the web applications or like complete user interactions, there will be very limited changes from as is to 2B, because in case if some process changes are required or the data is not standard, and if you want to keep the things to be standard, in those cases there will be a bit difference between the as is and 2B flow. And we will look into 2B flow and in the next video. And thanks for watching, and please like, subscribe and share Skill RPA.